To those of you who have joined us in person today, it's the hardest job I have to... I just went a little bit broken. There we go. It's the hardest job I have to break up all the Happy Sabbath conversations out there. But we want to get started because the Lord has a blessing in store for us today. If you are in the middle of a conversation that you must finish, you can. Just go out of this room and continue that conversation so we can continue to get started. And those of us who are looking forward to continuing can begin. It's going to be a great Christmas program. It's music and scripture in a flow that I believe will capture our imagination and help us relive the mystery of God coming down as man to rescue us. We have few announcements, not much. We're going to kind of keep moving this morning. Is Jade here? Jade's not here. Okay, so we're going to save that announcement. Zoltan has something that he's going to share with us after we get into our service. And we're going to just begin right away today with offering. We're going to not have children's story right after offering. We're going to continue right into the program today so that we can keep on pace and we can have lots of time and brain and emotional capacity to absorb what we have today. So this morning we're going to change things up a little bit. We're going to begin with prayer and then we're going to take up the offering. But right now we still have a lot of chatter here in the live service. So I'm going to do what my mom does in school. If you can raise your hand when you're ready to close your mouth. And then it'll get nice and quiet. And then whoever it is, whose turn it is to talk, can be heard by the rest of us. Okay. Please bow your heads with me as we continue in worship this morning. Heavenly Father, how do we thank you for the event we're celebrating this morning? We know it wasn't December 25, but it is the time that we look back on what heaven had been waiting for nearly 4,000 years. Lord, thank you for coming. May our hearts be just caught up with the mystery and the love that was poured into Jesus coming as a man to rescue us. And yet God coming to give his life so that we don't have to live the perfect life. Lord, this morning we pray for hearts that are humble. We pray for hearts that want to receive that forgiveness, that as the song says, you can be born in us today. Lord, please guide this service, guide as we give back of our tithes and offerings. Thank you for the privilege to continue in the mission that you started to rescue this world. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. As the deacons collect the tithe and offering, Pastor has a couple announcements that we'd like to bring to the church this morning.
Yes, good morning, and happy Sabbath. Glad to see you all here. I'm glad I'm here after being 2 weeks at Palms West, but had a good time over there. But a few of you came over and participated in the service there, so appreciate seeing you. Just a couple of things. We do have an item of business to take care of. Our treasurer, Ernie, has resigned his position as the head treasurer, but he's going to be an assistant to Suji, who will be our new treasurer. So we voted that as a board. We're bringing that to the church. We'll have the first reading, which I just did right now this week. And next Sabbath, we'll have the final reading, and then we'll take a vote on it. So we're required to have two announcements of the change. So that is done. So we'll have the second reading next week. Also, we want to be clear that our Christmas tree offering, this tree you see behind us, the offerings that are put on there are for our church budget. Now, we've had a couple of expenditures this past month. We had to get two water tanks that cost us about $5,000. So don't forget your offering in the church budget. You can specify that on your tithe envelope. I have mine here. Actually, this is for the Christmas tree. But so you could put in an offering now, or you could put it on a Christmas tree. But remember the church budget, because this is a wonderful facility, a wonderful church ground. And the only reason it's here is because of your offerings, not only to have built it, we still have a church to build, right? But also to sustain it. So remember the church offering today, either in your tithe envelope as you put it in a plate or on the Christmas tree. And I'm going to put my offering on there right now on the Christmas tree, so don't forget to do it. And I think we'll have a great service today, and the Lord will bless.
Before you go up, can you give us the short version of how our tithes and offerings are broken down? Because we do it a little different in our church versus some of the other churches that are out there.
Well, the tithe, we know, the 10%, God asks us to return that. That's to spread the gospel around the world. That supports pastors and teachers and missionaries and things like that. But the local offering is for our facilities here. It's just like when you buy a house, you have an electric bill, you have a water bill, you have a depreciation of appliances where you're going to have to repair when it breaks down. And so the church works the same way, much like a home. So that's why we want to remember the local church budget on your tithe envelope is very, very important. Yes, we want to remember other projects, world missionary offerings, and beside our tithe, but that is one of the things that we should remember, and that stays here in our church, the local church budget.
Thank you, Pastor. Zoltan, are you ready to come and give us the final rundown of how this is going to flow this morning? Zoltan has put a lot of time into preparing the flow, so we appreciate that. There's a lot of people who have been working to make this a special time of worship, and after he gives us our set of cues, this should flow pretty smoothly, so that those of you online can just have a blessed experience as well.
Happy Sabbath, brothers and sisters.
Happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath.
It's so good to be in the Lord's house this morning. Amen?
Amen.
So basically, the way this is set up, we are going to have a Bible verse before somebody praises the Lord, before someone serves. And I'm just going to pick someone at random. I'm just going to be honest. So we're going to have Bible verses, and then can you go to the third slide, please? Okay, so we see, as an example, that Yeti will be serving first, and then we see next, Barry. So whoever is listed as next on the bottom, please come to the back. We will give you a mic. When you are done serving, please come back and give the mic back, okay? That's all. So can we go back to the first one, and we will start our program. Okay, how about,
did you read the first verse?
Isaiah.
Tom's West tunes in at 11:30. We're a little early.
Oh, okay.
Can we sing a couple of songs on like we did, you know, having
Let's
a song
sing
for
a couple of songs. I'm sorry.
Okay.
My bad.
No, no, what you're doing.
My bad.
Okay, let's sing.
This is hot. This is good.
The red one is not picking up well. I don't know. As long as it's picking up online, that's okay. But
turn it.
Oh, come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. The morn's in lowly exile, until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Oh, come thy wisdom from high, and order all things far and nigh. To us the path of knowledge show, and cause us in her ways to go. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
That's it. Okay, what do we have another one? Can we risk taking one favorite? Can we risk taking one favorite, one Christmas carol favorite? I know you all, don't shout all at once.
Oh, yeah. Well, they much like Old Little Town of Bethlehem.
Okay, Old Little Town of Bethlehem, it'll be. You know, it's amazing. I've been singing to Rachel Christmas songs at night, and I can't think of all these. That's why we got to come to church to be reminded.
I know.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. Thy silent stars go by, yet in thy dark tree shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. Oh, morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his head. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Lord enters in. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend on us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Doesn't that song just about summarize
everything?
Everything.
Everything.
How silently the wondrous gift is given. No human may hear his coming. That's our prayer this Christmas. If Jesus isn't in our hearts, that he will be when we're finished.
I don't think it was a silent night. There was a lot of rejoicing. Angels were singing.
I know it wasn't very silent back then.
The shepherds were singing. Everything. There was a lot going on.
I think the angels were pretty eager to sing that song.
I know.
Let's sing Silent Night, Holy Night.
Silent night, holy night. All is calm, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child, holy so tender and mild. Sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, darkness flies, all is light. Shepherds hear the angels sing, hallelujah, hail the King. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, wondrous star, lend thy light, with the angels let us sing, hallelujah to our King. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
Ooh. One more, we get to start.
One more. Okay. What child is this? Somebody needs to turn the air on, don't you think?
I don't know.
They think it's cold.
I love how these songs capture the mystery and get your emotions to grasp the scenes. Ponder the message of this song. What child is this?
It doesn't touch you.
What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping? When angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. To bring him what the babe, the Son of Mary. Why does he in such meanness say, where ox and ash are feeding? Good Christians, far from sinners here, the silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. The babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him. The King of Kings salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him what the babe, the Son of Man.
Rachel's age, I didn't like that song because it sounded so mournful. But now that I'm older, I realize the music is written for us to sit back and ponder.
Yeah.
How is it that heaven could come down in a baby? How is it that the king of the creator that never had a beginning would have an end? So music is set to help us grasp some of the things that we can't just get by reading or by hearing words. Are we ready to continue in our worship? Okay, so we will continue with our program. Pastor has given us the thumbs up. So prepare to be blessed. And those of you online, we are beginning to begin.
Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Isaiah 9:6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Thank you. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house in the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
There's lots of songs about Mary and baby Jesus, but there's only one song I've ever found about Joseph. And that's what I'm going to sing again this year, Joseph's song. How could it be this baby sleeping here so peacefully? The Son of God. That's what the angel said. Oh, how could it be? How could it be? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh. Oh, not of my bone. But Father, I'm pleading, please, let this baby be son of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? All my life I've only been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? Raise a king. He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, why, the sun, it seems to disappear. Ah, but when he laughs, the sun seems to shine again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? All my life I've only been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be this baby sleeping here so peacefully? How could it be the Son of God? That's what the angel said. How could it be?
The time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night.
Silent night, holy night. silent night, holy night,
Son of God, lost pure light, radiant beams from thy holy face. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I will bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people."
Thank you. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord.
This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger.
Thank you. morning. How is everybody? Happy Shabbat. I would like to please ask all the children to come up front. I have a story for you. Oh, everybody's so shy today. Nobody wants to coming. Come on, come on. Hurry, because then I'll talk longer, you know. Who wants me to talk long? I don't think anybody, right? Okay, have a seat, have a seat. Come sit down, sit down. I have a story for you. But let me introduce myself first. My name is David, but I am not the King David. But like David, I was born and I live in Bethlehem. And I want to tell you a story that changed my life forever. Okay? You know, when I was a young boy, my father, his favorite king was King David. So he named me King David. And he tell me stories all the time. Do your parents tell you stories? Yes? Lots of stories? Yes? Well, my father, he always told me about a Messiah that is going to come. Okay? And I said, you know, I am 31 years old, right? No. But you know, I am getting older and nothing happening, right? So I forget about the stories, oh, whatever, you know. But we still pray about, we sing about Jesus, everything, right? And nothing happened. Well, you know, just like King David, who I'm named after, yes, you have a question?
When David killed Goliath.
Yes, but that is a different story. That is, we are not talking about when David killed Goliath now. That is a different story. So, I, like David was when he was younger, am a shepherd. Okay? And what do shepherds do? What do, yes. They protect the sheep, yes. Any, from danger, yes. If a wolf or a fox comes to grab, then we hit them on the head. Okay. Okay. Okay, what else do shepherds do?
My teacher told me a story about a shepherd that had a lot of sheep, and then one shepherd ran away.
Okay, but that is different story altogether. That is different story. No, no. What do shepherds do? Anybody else? Okay, what? They take care of the sheep. Yes? Yes, they yes, help them so they don't get hurt. Okay, one more. They rescue them. Okay, one more. Okay, yes, we build the fences, but, I mean, it is all about protecting, right? But one thing that you did not say is we also sleep with the sheep. You know, that is why I also stink sometimes, okay? So, I was sleeping next to my friend one day, and out of the sudden, very, very bright light. You ever walk into a dark, you ever be in a dark room and the light goes on and you're like, oh, what is going on? Ever do that? You never do that? Okay, you've seen that. Okay. All of a sudden, very dark night and bright sky. And I cannot see what is going on. And I look and I'm looking and there, the sky is full. The sky is full. You know what it's full of? Angels. So stand up, angels. Stand up, angels. The sky is full of angels. And they start to sing. Yes, yes. Okay, but let me finish the story now. Okay, you are very eager, very eager. So they start to sing. And this most beautiful music I ever heard in my life. I at first I very afraid. I don't know what to do. And an angel says, fear not, for I come to you with great tidings or good tidings of great joy. For today, a baby born in Bethlehem, right? And his name is Jesus. Okay? He come and he tell us of that the Messiah is here. I cannot believe it. The Messiah. All the stories, they come back to me. And I think of All everything my father told me, and all the prayers and all the songs and everything we talk about in church, that Jesus is here? It cannot be. Well, they're singing the most beautiful music. And you know what? I said, let us go and see Mary and Joseph, right? But I did not know their name at the time, of course, right? Who knows at that time? Let us go see this baby Jesus. And then we walking, and then we get to Mary and Joseph. And, yes? Yes? Where did we know where to go? We follow the sheep. That is how we know where to go. We just follow the sheep. We let them graze. So we arrive in the manger, but we did not know where to go. Well, the angel help us. Come on up here. So we are walking, we shepherds, we are walking through the city, ready to rejoice with the rest of the city. And you know what everybody is doing? Everybody asleep. And I said, wow, we just saw the most beautiful thing that I have ever seen in my life. And we go into the city and nobody knows. Nobody knows that the angels were singing, glory to God in the highest. I was so disappointed. Yes. They were very deep sleep, yes, yes. And we get to the manger, and I see Jesus, and I see Mary and Joseph. And I say, this is the Savior of the world. I cannot picture right now. But I know that he is going to grow up, that the Lord and the angels will be with him, and he will save us from our sins. And you know, when I think about all the stories that my parents told, or your parents told you, yes, because I am David, when I think about all the stories that Jesus will come again someday, you know, we have to remember that he will come in the clouds of glory, just like the angels sang in the clouds of glory. And you know, we have to have faith and hope that he will come again, just like he came the first time, and he promised to come a second time to take us home. We have to remember that we should not be caught asleep like everybody in Bethlehem was. Okay? So I hope you never forget this story, because it changed my life forever. And I hope it changed yours. And you look at this story a little bit differently than you did before. God bless you. Okay, you guys can go back to your seats.
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men.
has happened, which... When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Peace upon earth, the angels sang, goodwill unto men, the chorus rang. Glory to God, the Christ has come, his bright shine stars in the clear blue dawn.
Joyously sing, joyously sing, joyously sing, joyously sing.
Luke 2:17-18. When they had seen him, they made widely known the thing which was told them concerning the child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds.
Amen. Oh, that was wonderful. And the whole program was such a blessing, wasn't it?
Amen.
Wow. You know, all of this, all of the joy, all of the good feelings, all of the love we feel is only because Jesus came here 2,000 years ago and was born as a baby in Bethlehem, grew up as a man, taught us what God was like, and then died on the cross, so we can be here today. You know, I hope that you have a wonderful week. Merry Christmas. I know even with the virus, people still be gathering, but let's be careful. Let's pray that God would help us to be safe and that he would protect us from the virus. And the time we have together, let's cherish it because, you know, tomorrow's not promised, but today is. So I think that's the end of our program. So why don't we just stand as much as possible, then we'll bow our heads and we'll have a closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you today for the blessings that we have received by being here today to hear the music, whether on instrument or by voice, whether in person or on the screen today. Lord, it's all been such a blessing. We feel the warmth. We feel the love. We're so thankful that we can be part of the churches here in the Jupiter Church and the Palms West Church, and that we're part of a family, the family of God, the body of Christ. And Lord, we do pray as we come to a close of this year, and what a year it has been. We look forward with hope to the new year that will be shortly here, with hope that this year will be a better year, that this terrible scourge, this virus, will be done away with, and that we will have a healthy and a happy new year together as a church spreading the good news of the gospel to a world that so desperately needs it. So, Lord, we want to thank you for our families, our loved ones that you have given us. We're thankful for the church and for the love we see from member to member. And most of all, we're thankful that you gave us Jesus, who is our constant companion through the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. We pray that we would always be grateful, that we would always be thankful for the only reason we can stand here and have peace on earth during this season is because Jesus paid the price for our peace. So we do pray now, dear Lord, as we conclude our service, that you would keep us safe. People will be traveling to and fro on aeroplanes, by car, by rail. Lord, protect each person that will be traveling. Put a hedge of protection around us. And then when we meet again here, we do pray that each one of us will have a safe Christmas, a blessed Christmas. And we thank you for hearing us, and we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all.